Good evening. Today we are going to see the forces in members, and that due to dead load, live load, and wind load. Now already we have seen this. We have this graphical method, and by using this graphical method, we are in position to find the forces in members. Already we have plotted this. So we are with space diagram, and then by space diagram, we are with this as force diagram. So this as force diagram. So these two we have already plotted. And now we are interested to determine the force in each member. Now in this, I have considered scale as 1 centimeter equal to 1.12. Actually, I have considered 0.9 centimeter, that is equal to 1.01, because it is not possible for me to accommodate with larger scale in this PPT, and therefore I have reduced it, and that goes to 1 centimeter equal to 1.12. And by using this scale, I have calculated forces in these members. Now you can see this. So we have first AB. So AB, I have measured B1. So we have this as B1. So you have to measure this B1. So B1 is measured. And by measuring this B1, we have to multiply it by 1.12. So you can have 23.627 multiplied by 1.12, you will get 26.51. Now, how I will find nature of force in this member? So already I have explained this. Again, I will tell you how you will go for this. So we have diagram in this fashion. So we have force over here, 10.1, 1.01. So we have this 10.1, 1.01. And we have in this force in this member. So I will say we are interested to find nature of this. So we have this as B, we have this as 1. Now we are going from B to 1. So because we have to go clockwise by Bose notation, so B to 1. So I have B over here and 1 here. So we are going in downward direction. So I will show arrow downward. So as it is downward, means we have that as compression. Now if we will go to member AC, so we have to measure AC, you can see over here. So if I will go with AC, then we have this force in member, that is 1C. So we have 1C, so we have to measure this length 1C, which is horizontal length, and I have measured this length, and by this length we are going to get force in the member AC. So now we have this as 1M. 22.25 is length, and 24.92 by multiplying 1.12. Now nature of this, now you can see, you have to go from 1 to M. So 1 to M, 1 we are over here, M we are over here. So we are going towards right. So I will show towards right, and you can see we are going to get tension. So likewise, you have to find forces in members. So we have BD then. We have measured 23.67, so it comes 26.51 compression. Then likewise, we have measured the length and we have multiplied by 1.12. That will give me forces in the member. And nature, I just explained, you have to go clockwise. And by going clockwise, you are going to get these values. Now you can see, we have this 2, 1. So 2, 1, so we have this length. So we have measured this 2, 1. And then this length we have 1.8 multiplied by 1.12, we will get 2.02. Now you can see nature of this also. I will show you again one joint, and then I will go ahead of this. So we have, this will be my joint B. Then we have this as B. Then this will be 1, C, and 2. We have to go again clockwise. We have force here also, which is 2.02. Now then we have C to 2. So from C, we have to go towards. So sorry, this is yes, C to 2. Now C we have here. So C to 2 means we have to come downward. So we have to come downward. So we will get force in the member as compression. So you can see this member is B, D. So member B, D, if you will see, you have compression. Now you can have, you have to go 2 to 1. So 2 we have here and then 1 up. Then I have to go upward. So we have to go upward. Then we have 1, 2. That member we have B, C. And then BC, you can see we have compression. So then CD, then we have to go to the next joint. And then likewise, you can find the forces in members. So if you have to go CD, you can see over here CD. So we have this member. So we have to go for 2 to 3. So 2 to 3, we have 2 over here. We have 3 over here. So we have to go up. And then if you will plot it going up, then we are going to get tension. CD, you can see we have tension. So likewise, you have to find the nature of the force, nature of the forces and value. We are already mentioned, you have to just multiply length by your scale. Suppose you have taken 1 centimeter as 1.01, then you have to multiply it, whatever 1 centimeter you have considered. So multiply by that length by 1.12 or whatever scale you have, and you will get force in the member. And by nose, you have to actually go to find the force in the member by this multiplying, and then by these considering joint separately, you are in position to find out the nature of the forces. Now whatever value we have calculated that are correct or not, we have to check it at one section, and if that is correct, then whatever we have done, that we are going to say it is okay for all. So now we are going to consider a section. So we have taken this section that is through member. So we have, this is FH. Then we have F, force in FH. Then we have this as force in GH. And then we have this as, we can see over here. So we have FH, then GH, and then we have GI. So we have force this GI. We will check these three. And if these three are correct, means our calculations, or we can say graphical method, is correct. Now we are going to find first force in member FGH. Now in section method, we are going to consider a joint through which remaining members are passing. How many members are cut by the section? So three members are cut by section. One is FH, then second we have GH, and third is GI. Now in this, I will say which two members are passing through the point. So we can have FGH also, FGI also. And then I have to go for component of this FH. Instead of this, your force FH passing through A and GI also passing through A. So I will take moment about A. So automatically FH and GI will be passing through this. So moment of these two are zero. And component of FGH, horizontal component of FGH also passes through A, so it becomes zero. Because if we will consider force in this member as tensile, then we will come across two components. We will get one component vertical, and then we will get another component as horizontal. This horizontal component again passes through A, so we have to take moment of this only. And this angle we have, that angle we know, which is 55.41. And then we will go moment about A0. So you can see this FGH sine 55.41 into 4.8. So we have this as 1.6 meter, 1.6 meter. And again, we have this as 1.6 meter. So FGH sine 55.41 into 4.8. So we have. So we have this value that is minus 2.02 into 4.8. So we have taken this 2.02 because we have this value as 1.6, 1.6 and 1.6. And therefore, if we will go with two component of this, we have this component as sine and this component as cos. And we have this angle as 55.41. And from this, we will get it as FGS sine 55.41 into 4.8 minus 2.02 into 4.8. actually if we will consider anti-clockwise minus, then this will be minus plus. Sign convention you have to keep, whichever is plus, whichever is minus. And by this, we are going to get this 2.02 of this into 3.2 and 2.02 into 1.6. And from this, we will get value of FGH 4.91 kilonewton tension. Then we can see FGH, we have 4.97 kilonewton, and that is tension. So we have all these forces that are in kilonewtons. Then we can apply summation FY0. And from this, we will get FGH sine 55.41 upward. Then minus FHF sine 19.33, because now we have these three members, 1, 2, and 3. Out of this, we have calculated this member. And this F, we can say F GI, this member do not have any vertical component. So we can find by FY0 force in member FHF, and that is this member. And in this member, we have considered that is compression, and therefore we are going to get this component that will be minus FHF sine 19.33 minus. Now we have these three forces, 2.02, which are y direction. So minus 3 into 2.02, then minus 1.01, and then plus 10.1. And from this, we will get value of FHF 20.74 kilonewton compression. So HF. So we have HF, that is 20.60 kilonewton compression. We have, this will be my force in the member, which will be HF. Then we will go with third force in the member, which we have FX0, because now FGI, we are only in X direction. And therefore, we have considered tension in this member FGI. And then we have minus F. HF cos 19.33 plus FGH cos 55.41 plus FGI, and that is equal to zero. And from this, we are going to get value of FGI, and that value we have 16.70 kilonewton tension. So GI, we have 16.70 kilonewton tension. So we have this will these three forces, and we have values are same. And then we will go with value of forces in member due to live load. And in this, we have force in member due to live load, and that is equal to force in member due to dead load into live load into upon dead load. So we are going to multiply by this factor, that is 2.35 upon 2.02, because for 2.02, we have this force in the member, and we are interested to find out for 2.35. And therefore, just multiply this force in member 26.51, that is by 2.35 upon 2.02, so that is 30.84 kilonewton. Nature we have same, because we have forces in vertical direction only. So likewise, we are in position to calculate the forces in all members, and these forces we are going to get, that is due to live load. So we have these two forces we got in the members, and also we got the nature of the forces in the member due to dead load and live load. So today we will stop here only. Remaining part we will see in the next lecture. So thank you.